Hi, today I'm going to cut down a tree that's been getting in my way on one of my access roads on the back 40. Let's go take a look. I use this access road once in a while to get in the backwoods here, and this one maple tree seems like it's been leaning a little bit more every year. And as you can see, it's right over my access road. And as I drive through here with the truck, I really have to kind of weave through to get through, and it's getting tougher and tougher. And I think my truck just barely misses the edge of this tree. So I want to take it down. As you can see, it's got quite a lean to it, and it's kind of close to another tree in the upper canopy there. What I plan to do is have a shallow notch on this tree, maybe like right here, and so that when the tree falls, it doesn't pinch on that notch. So it'll be a fairly long notch. And then what I'll do is I'll plunge cut the tree here, and then make sure my hinge is about the right depth. And then once I'm ready, I'll just finish right through on this tree, and it should fall the way it's leaning. I don't really want to challenge the lean of the tree, because it's got a mind of its own, and it wants to fall in a certain place. And if I can just allow it to do that without getting hurt, I'll be happy. On a tree like this with that big of a lean on it, we'll want to barber chair if you don't cut it right. And if I were to notch it and then cut it from this way, it could break off in the middle before I get it all the way through and split, and the whole tree can come up in the air like that. And you don't know how long a barber chair it might be. It could be 20 feet long, and it could wipe you out when it sweeps by. So let's get to work on this tree and see what happens. One of the things I'm a little concerned about is how it's tangled with that other tree up on the top. And so when I drop it, it could make this tree kind of twist as it falls, and it could barber chair kind of sideways in this direction. So once I get that cut released, I'm going to want to skedaddle out of here. You should always have a good escape route, and my escape route this time is going to be right up my access road here. And one protection I have, I think, is if something goes wrong, this tree here could block that from going any further down this access road. So let's give it a try and see what happens. All right, so I got my notch cut in the tree, and I got it notched in the direction that I want it to fall over here. So next is to do a plunge cut right through the middle there, make sure my hinge is about the right depth, and then just keep on going right through. As you can see, I've got the notch so that it's about 80% of the width of the tree. So it's far enough in. So let's do that plunge cut. Okay, so I got the plunge cut done, and the hinge is about the same depth on both sides. So next thing is just to put the saw in the plunge cut and just run it right up through the back, and that should release the tree. So this is the exciting part, so let's see what happens. Okay, we got her done. Let's see what we could have done any different. It came out okay, but a few minor things, because it started to fall before I was all the way through the trigger. And you can see just a little bit of it came off. It was really minor, not a problem. And overall, I would say we got it done the way I wanted to do it. Kind of fell in between those trees. And the only thing I think I should have done differently is when I was running away from the cut here, I should have pushed my lock on my chain so that if I fell, it wasn't running, or I couldn't, the chain wouldn't move. But I'd say overall, I'm going to call that a success, and that's how you release a leaner. Now it's just a matter of getting this all cut up and hauled to the woodshed. So I got the portion of the tree cut up that was blocking the road here, and I think I'll work on that first and come back for the rest of the tree later. So I gotta split these up and get them on the truck. Well, that's all I've got for today. Be safe out there. See you next time.